Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's a trailblazer, trendsetter, and she won our hearts with her iconic role as Thelma Evans from CBS's sitcom Good Times, Good Times.
Yes, please welcome the legendary and beautiful actress and author, Bern Nadette Stanis. Yay! Yes!
Hello!
Yes!
Royalty, royalty, oh, royalty!
Yes!
Oh, thank you, darling.
Yes.
So good to see you.
Yes,
have a seat right here. You still just look so
amazing.
How do you keep it all together?
Well, I don't know. I just keep, I jog and I, you know, drink a lot of water.
Right.
And, you know, eat some vegetables.
Eat some vegetables. Yes, still just as gorgeous as ever.
Yes, I mean, I just remember, we just watched you guys all the time. Me and my sister, we used to do, put them on and burn out. You remember that? Yes! It's so iconic. I mean, it was one of our favorite sitcoms of all times. Mm-hmm. How did you even get started in the business?
Well, I was in a beauty pageant and a manager saw my mom and came over to me and, I mean, came over to my mom and said that Norman Lear is doing a TV show and your daughter looks like she can fit in there. So of course, you know, we went up to CBS and there were thousands of girls.
Right. You're like, what? Right.
You know, and then of course, you know, I auditioned with Jimmy Walker and Norman Lear and, you know, I improvised. I just could not read that script. So I improvised. He allowed me to do it.
Really?
Yeah. And, you know, I just hit Jimmy and carried on. And so it was funny the way we carried on because I do that with my real brothers.
Right.
Did you think it was going to be as large as it was?
Never. Mm-hmm. Never. It was just a wonderful show. I was just so happy to be a part of that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I had no idea, like 42 years later, that it's like an iconic show.
Yes, yes.
You know, because it was a trailblazer.
It was, it was. You know what? You personified black girl magic before it had a name. You know what I'm saying? Everybody was like, man, she's so fine.
Yes.
And you were the first African American teenager, female, on television.
Yes.
How does that make you feel? Or do you still sit in that some from time to time? And how do we keep that going?
Well, you know, it's amazing that, you know, at that time, I didn't realize that, but, you know, I was the first one, and I think that's why all the guys, you know, liked me, you know, kind of thing. You were my first girlfriend.
Right.
I sit in it today because I'm very proud of the women that are successful today, and, you know, I know that I was one of the first, and so we didn't have a lot of people to hang out with and all that, but you guys are so lucky these days that you have so many.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I'm proud of you.
And that was, like, one of the first times we actually saw a hard-working black family on television. Did you all know the importance of it then?
I think Esther Roll did. John Amos certainly did. They did know. I did not know the importance of. I knew it was very important, but I didn't know how important it was. And so, you know, Esther made sure that we had a father in the show and that we presented ourselves as a beautiful black family, although we were struggling. We had love, and at that time, most families were in the projects. You know, these days, you know, the new generation, projects what, you know?
Right.
Yeah, so that's what happened with us, you know? And so we were really, you know, like, you know, the forerunners and John and Esther really fought for us.
They did.
Know?
We had John here, I think our first year. And
he was
like, yeah, he talked about how, you know, he wanted to change some things up.
Yes.
And, which is why he wanted to see the black family progress.
Yes, he did.
And when it wasn't progressing anymore, he had to bow out. So that's, he talked about that.
Yes, I know. But we were so sad when he had to leave.
Yeah,
it changed it a little bit. But Good Times had so many dynamics to it. If you look at it, we had the adoption, we had single parent, we had, you know, remarriage, you know, whole thing. You know? So we touch a lot of people.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Let's talk a little bit about your book. And you believe, well, your mother,
she had Alzheimer's.
Last night, we're talking about the caregiver side of that. And I know that people don't always talk about the caregiver. Why was it so important?
Well, it was important because I wanted my mother to write a book about her life. She was such a beautiful mother, you know, and for something like that to happen to her, I didn't understand that. So as a caregiver, you know, it was very difficult. And we go through these things, you know, being ignorant of the disease, which, you know, African Americans get it twice as much as anyone gets it, you know. So being so ignorant about that, I was just praying to God, you know, and giving her vitamins and minerals, just this, we're gonna conquer this Alzheimer's thing. But, you know, I come to find out that that's not true. Mm-hmm. And it is a very, you know, it's devastating and it's a fatal disease.
Yeah.
You know, and they say it's in the families and stuff like that. But I don't want to believe that. I want to believe that it's not habitual. It's habitual, not hereditary.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. So why don't you talk to us about your Alzheimer's Foundation?
Well, I have one called Remembering the Good Times, an Alzheimer's Foundation. And it was given that name because my mother was watching Good Times with me. Mm-hmm. And she looked up at me and said, you know, that's a cute little old girl.
Oh, yeah.
So she did not know it was me.
Yeah.
You know, and that's a devastating thing, you know. You know, she didn't know my name. So a lot of times they don't remember your name, mm-hmm. but my mother remembered my name. But she just didn't know I was Thelma.
Yeah.
You know, so I said, when this thing is done, I call it the monster of the mind. Mm-hmm. And when this is done, I'm going to name a foundation in her honor called Remembering the Good Times and Alzheimer's Foundation.
She's very proud of you. She's very proud of you. You have a new television project.
Yes.
Well, so tell us all about it.
Well, big shot. I am going to be the CEO of a failing radio station.
Uh-huh.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Because it's happening.
That's right. And we have our little meeting and everything, and at the end of the meeting, I tell everybody to take their newsletter and their little Danishes and everything, and then I have to tell them that it's a day-old Danish,
mm-hmm.
but if you put it in the microwave,
It's still good. Well, we thank you so much. You're amazing. We just love you.
I love you guys.
Yes.
You're doing such a wonderful job.
Thank you so much.
And you're so gorgeous.
Oh my God.
I thought it was just television. It's real.
Yes. Thank you. Well, make sure to keep up with Bern Nadette. Be sure to follow her on Instagram @Thelma of Good Times.